said, Pastor Vic, I'm so sorry I cannot go because I have no car right now. I said, you have no car, you are working and you work a lot of overtime and your wife is working, making more than what you are making, and you telling me you have no car. And he told me so many reasons behind it. And I said, brother, that is not the will of God for you. You're receiving this much every month, and yet you are in poverty. You even experience bankruptcy, spiritual bankruptcy, material bankruptcy, financial bankruptcy. This is not the will of God. The will of God for us is to have a goal, goal that will make us successful in life. Man, you guys are so quiet today. Goal that will make us people that belong to the kingdom of God. Not just by word, it's by what people see. You don't have to say anything, but people will say, wow, something good is going on in your life. I knew you before. You used to be like this. You used to be like this. And now look at you. That's the type of commendation that we have to receive from other people, that you used to be like this, you used to be like that. Some people told me, you know what? I saw you before. Before you don't look like that, and now you look so nice. And you look so rich. I said, just look. Wait till it materialize. Amen. Amen. How many here wants the people to see you? Oh, I know you before, remember? You driving Mercedes and now you have no car. Of course, nobody wants to receive that kind of statement coming from your friend that knew you. They know your family, and yet they know you like you are so high. And right now, it's opposite. Totally opposite. I'd rather people telling me, you used to be like this, and now you are high. And all that you may say is this, it's because of God. It's because of God. Amen?
Amen, yes.
Hallelujah. That's why, my brother, my sisters, setting goals will make you become excellent. One of my favorite teacher and mentor in our time right now is this man by the name of John Maxwell. John Maxwell has plenty of books. Books that will give you direction, that will boost your mentality to think big, because your God is big. He is not a positive preacher. He is a man of leadership. And he says, the only reason people will follow you when they saw something good is happening in your life. You cannot get followers. How can a blind lead another blind? You got to be a man of vision. a man of direction, a man of goal, and aiming to accomplish that goal. Remember when Jesus came to this earth? His main purpose, his main goal, because he knew that he has a purpose by becoming a human being like you and me. Though he was 100% God, but his main focus, his main goal is to accomplish his mission. You have a mission in life. I have a mission in life. That's why we have to set up goals. We have to set up something that will bring us into a higher level of our walk with the Lord. I've been asking God to show me a clear direction, because goals can keep us moving on the path toward the ultimate success. How many here wants to become successful in life? I want to become successful. I want to see my children successful, complete what they want to complete as a student, as a young people at this time. I want to see every one of them setting up goals that will bring them into a higher level of their service to the Lord. Goal setting and achievement keep us fresh and alive. Goal setting. Look at here in the book of Acts chapter 20. The book of Acts chapter 20, let me read from verse 22. And it says, Acts 20 verse 22. And see, now I go bound in the Spirit to Jerusalem, not knowing the things that will happen to me there, except that the Holy Spirit testifies in every city, saying that chains and tribulation await me. But none of these things move me, nor do I count my life dear to myself, so that I may finish my race. Ooh. He forgot about himself. He focused on the finish line.